So today we will be learning the chapter carbon and its compounds. This chapter is very, very important. Now every year in your board exams, this chapter is being set for 8 marks. Science paper is set for 80 marks. Out of that, chemistry is given 25 marks weightage. You have 5 chapters of chemistry. Now from those 5 chapters of chemistry, carbon and its compounds is given the maximum weightage. Alright? And it is 100% that you will get a 5 marker from this chapter. So that is the marking scheme or the blueprint I have given for carbon and its compounds. So it is must that you will get a 5 marker. Then you will also get a 3 marker, or those 3 marks will be divided as 2 mark short answer and 1 mark for one word question, or the first question which has 1 markers. Then second thing is, this chapter, as the name indicates, carbon and its compounds. Now carbon comes in organic chemistry. Now carbon also, when it is forming compounds with these other elements like oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, hydrogens, then they come in organic chemistry. Now in grade 11 and 12, you have bigger chapters or bigger topics on organic chemistry. So to learn them, you need to know some basics, a few basics of organic chemistry, and that is the reason this chapter has been introduced in grade 10. Now first of all, let us get to know carbon a little. Now carbon in your periodic table is the 6th element, and you should know that in the periodic table, all the elements are placed according to their atomic number. If you remember 9th grade concepts, then you should know what is atomic number. Atomic number is the number of protons present in an atom. Alright, that is the number of protons. Because an atom is electrically neutral, so the number of protons are always equal to the number of electrons. So all the elements are placed in the periodic table according to their atomic numbers. So if some element has one atomic number, that will be kept first. Two atomic number, second. So carbon has 6 atomic numbers, so it is given the place 6. Alright, now I told you what is atomic number. Atomic number is number of protons. And because an atom is electrically neutral means the charge will be balanced. As many protons are there, same number of electrons will be there. Right? So overall charge on an atom is 0. So if its atomic number is 6, there are 6 electrons. And there is a rule for stability. That also you have learnt in grade 9. So how do you distribute these 6 electrons of carbon? We distribute them as 2, 4. Now the first shell, which is K, its capacity is also 2. Second shell, L, its capacity is 8. Now every shell's capacity should be satisfied in order to make an atom stable. Right? Now to make it stable, there are 2 options with carbon. Either taking 4 electrons or give out 4 electrons. But can carbon do that? Now two major things I am going to tell you. For an atom to remove electrons, there is an energy required. It is called as ionization energy. What energy? Ionization energy. Now here, this is carbon with 2 shells. Right? Last shell has 4 electrons. Inner shell has 2 electrons. An equal amount of protons are there in the center. Now, to remove 1 electron, there will be some energy required. Now, why are we requiring these energies? Why? Because there is a force of attraction between the nucleus and these electrons. We are putting in some energy to remove the electron. Why is there any kind of energy expenditure? Because the electrons are bound with the nucleus tightly. This distance is very less, because there are only 2 shells, so the size is small, right? And now at a smaller distance, force of attraction will be very high. As close the electrons and protons are, the force of attraction between them will be more, right? So in such a case, if I try and remove 4 electrons, now why am I removing these 4 electrons? To tell you that, now every atom tries attaining noble gas configuration to be stable. What does it mean? I'll take two noble gases, helium and neon. Now atomic number of helium is 2, atomic number of neon is 10. Atomic number means the number of protons, that means they have the same number of electrons. Now it will have 2 electrons, those 2 electrons will be in K shell. This will have 2 and 8 electrons. This will have 10 electrons. And how will you distribute those electrons? Into K and L shells. K shell has capacity of 2. L shell has capacity of 8. Now out of 10, if I keep 2 here, 8 will obviously go in L shell. Now because here it has only one shell and that shell is full. It has 2 shells and both the shells are full. Because the shells are completely satisfied or completely filled, these are stable. And that is the reason they never react. Because reacting means you are unstable. That means the atom is unstable. To attain stability, it is reacting. Attain noble gas configuration, either it can lose 4 electrons and have 2 electrons in the first shell, or it can add 4 electrons and become 2,8, and that will be noble gas configuration 2,8, right? That is to attain stability. Now both the cases carbon cannot follow, because as I told you, here force of attraction is so high that if it is removing 4 electrons at a time, it will require a lot of ionization energy. Now what is this ionization energy? Ionization energy means the energy required to remove an electron from the last shell of an atom. Okay? Now, if I am removing 4 electrons, the energy required will be very high. And carbon cannot afford this much of ionization energy. Secondly, now if it has to take in 4 electrons, so total protons inside are 6, as that is the atomic number of carbon, right? So total protons are 6 and total electrons are also 6. Now if it wants to be stable by taking in 4 electrons, total number of electrons will be 10. Now it is very difficult for 6 protons or the nucleus with 6 protons to hold up to 10 electrons. 1 electron taken in is manageable. Even 2 is manageable. But 4 electrons taken in will burden the nucleus. And that is not possible again. So both the cases are not possible. So in this case, what will carbon do? Because carbon cannot give out electrons, cannot take in electrons. So the only option left with carbon is to shed electrons. Understood?